the Holy, unsubstantial, not creating the indivisible Trinity, always now and ever unto the ages of ages.
Lady, the most blessed, glorious Lady, the most blessed ever Virgin Mary with all the saints,
Let us commit ourselves to one another and all our life into Christ our God. Unto these your glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and to the ages of ages.
Thank you. For this Lord's having sent will be chanting before Saint us. Rejoice, O Lord, O Prophecy, boast, O Lord, self of the name of Russia, deserves to be known. All possessed of great mercy, Christ God, crown you with priest of immortal glory.
O praise the Lord, holy nations, praise and glory, people.
With all beauties of divinity, show praise the blessed kingdom, all worth the reigns and wings of divine understanding, soul aloft in the earth and heaven, and through mighty throne of the Holy Trinity, and gladness, joy, and foresting angels, praying to Christ, the holy Lord of the world, and the preservation of our man from hostile invasion, civil strife. O ye who men praise with love and cease to
And for all the people here present that are with me, great let us simply hear our evening prayer to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. That the holy evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. An angel of peace, a faithful guide and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord. Things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. A Christian ending to our life, aimless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Calling to remembrance of most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady, Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God. For a good God art thou, the lover of mankind, unto thee we send our glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all. Let us bow our heads unto the Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
Thank you.
Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
For the King shall be glad in God, every one shall be praised that sweareth by him, for the wealth of them instructs that speak and justice knows. And the day that I take him, the bell that come on the bridge, shall proclaim so I rejoice. My soul hath praised God to thee, that I shall not think quick to help thee. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, that is now and in the last age, to the ages, amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and to the ages, to the ages, amen. Before thee, just my prayer unto thee, for that thy merit to my supplication. With love of thee, voices my soul and my life unto Hades at the throne now. I am counted with them like a grand shepherd, my independence and hand of that hope, free among the dead like a body to the slain that sleep in the grave. And thou rememberest their mourning, and they have cut off from my hand. They laid me in the lowest pit in darkness and in the shadow of death. Against me is thy name made strong, and all thy glories hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends from me, they have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up and have not come forth, my eyes have grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long, I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Made for the devil, thou Lord, bondage, which our physicians praise and equal thee, and give thanks unto thee. May shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy and of thy truth in that destruction. May shall thy wonders be known in that darkness and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten. Blessed me unto thee, O Lord, and I cried in heaven, and when shall my prayer come before thee? Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast my soul? Dost thou cast off my soul, and turnest thy face away from me? A poor man am I, and in troubles for my youth, yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy furies have passed upon me, and thy cares have sorely troubled me. They came round about me like a daughter, orderly long they come consume about it today. Thou hast removed apart from me, friend made by my acquaintances because of my misery. O Lord, God of my salvation, by day, that I cried and by night before thee, because my prayer come before thee, that I am done, hear unto my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is with me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that thank the God of all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion. He fulfilleth thy desire of good things, thy wish shall be renewed as an eagle's. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all men that are wronged. He hath made his ways known unto Moses unto the sons of Israel, things that he hath built. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto the end of the day, but neither unto the eternity of the dearth. And according to our iniquities have he dealt with us, neither according to our sins have he rewarded us. But according to the night given from the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy story over them that fear him. As the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. And as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so hath his Lord hath compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth whereof the iniquity is from him that sheareth us. But as the man whose days are as the grass, as the clerical field, so shall he blossom forth. When the wind is past over, the wind shall be down, and the wind will know the place of all. For the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon sons and sons upon them that keep his testament. And by his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his highways, and in the way of the Lord. Bless the Lord, O ye his angels, his might and strength that perform his work, in the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, O ye his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, O ye his works, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. In the place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. The Lord, hear my prayer, give me unto my supplication and my truth. I come to me in thy righteousness, and yet in not into judgment with my soul. In thy sight shall my mind never be justified, for the only good persecuted myself with the power of my life down to you. For the sapping of darkness is those who have been long dead, and my spirit of the nature comes to stand it, for me when I have also struggled. I remember the days of all, I meditated in all thy works, I pondered on them, the conditions of thy hands, I stretched forth my hands unto thee. My soul first took heart to thee like a water this land, but with only a Lord, my spirit hath turned to the Lord. Shall not thy face away from me, lest I be like unto them that go down into the pit. Cause me to give thy mercy in the morning, for I come to thee, I have put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for unto thee, I have lifted up my soul. Cause me for my enemies, O Lord, unto thee, I have hope for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God, the good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Thy name's sake, O Lord, shall be quickened in me. And thy righteousness shall thou bring my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shall thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt go forth and afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. Hearken unto me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Hearken unto me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. My good spirit shall live in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Alleluia, 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 for the Spirit of God. Alleluia, 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 for the Spirit of God. Alleluia, 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 for the Spirit of God.
In peace let us pray to the
Lord.
For the peaceful love and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple, and for them that with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, and hearing, let us pray to the Lord. For our great Lord and Father, His Holiness Patriarch Cadeo, for our Lord, the Right Reverend Bishop Nicholas, newly elected, first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, and for our Lord, the Right Reverend Bishop George, for the venerable priesthood and the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord. For this land, its authorities and armed forces, and for all who with faith and piety dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord. For the God preserve Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That He may deliver His people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, every city and country, and the faithful that dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord. For seasonable weather, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, land, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That He may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by Thy grace. Calling to remembrance of most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady, we have her cursed ever Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God. Unto these to all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
Amen.
In the fifth tone, God is the Lord, and He hath appeared unto us. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. We give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endureth forever. Me and by the name of the Lord our God and them all. I shall not die but live, and I shall tell of the works of the Lord. The stone which the builders rejected, the same has become the head of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
Thank you.
multitude of thy mercy shall I go into thy house. I shall worship before thy holy temple in fear of thee. O Lord, guide me in the way of thy righteousness because of mine enemies, make straight my way before thee. For in their mouth there is no truth, their heart is vain. Their throat is an open sepulchre, but their tongues have they spoken deceitfully. Judge them, O God. Let them fall down on account of their devisings, according to the multitude of their ungodliness. Cast them out, for they have admitted to thee, O Lord. And let them be glad and hope in thee, for they shall ever rejoice. And thou shalt dwell among them, and all shall glory in thee that love thy name. For thou shalt bless the righteous, O Lord, as with the shield of thy good pleasure, as thou crowned us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Open, maybe spread the very pride after the apostles have been themselves. And forth you may for the patients of blessed ones, heal our infirmities, diseases, and deliver from all temptations. Those who have faith, praise your memory. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, from that is praised. Amen. All creation, descend your veins, and the human race, rejoice in thee, O thou art full of grace. O sacred disease and thou paradise, thou boast of patients from whom God who existed, from before time, was incarnate and became a child. But he made the loins and throne, and the womb he made more spacious than heavens. All creation rejoices in thee, for thou art full of grace, glory to thee.
Need
because they believed not them which had seen him after he was risen. And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And this sign shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues, they shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them, and they shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. So then after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven, and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them, and confirming the word with signs following. Inheritance, visit thy world with mercy and compassion, Exalt the Lord of Orthodox Christians, and send down upon us thine abundant mercies, through the intercessions of our Immaculate Lady, Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary, through the power of the precious and life-giving cross, through the mediations of the Honourable Heavenly Bodiversos, of the Honourable Glorious Prophet Forerunner and Baptist John, of the Holy Glorious and All-Praised Apostles, of our Fathers among the Saints, the Great Ecumenical Teachers and Hierarchs, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, of our Father among the Saints, Nicholas the Wonderworker, Archbishop of Mar and Lycia, of the Holy Eagles of the Apostles, Methodius and Cyril, Teachers of the Slavs, of the Holy Right-Believing Eagles of the Apostles, Great Prince Vladimir, and the Blessed Great Princes of Russia, Olga, of our Fathers among the Saints, among the Workers of all Russia, Michael, Peter, Alexis, Jonah, Philip, Macarius, Demetrius, Metrophans, Deacon Theodosius, Joseph, Hermogenes, Peter, Innocent, and John, of the Holy Hermanus and Confessors, Stephen, Patriarch of Moscow, Vladimir of Kiev, Benjamin and Joseph of Petrograd, Peter of Kutitsa, Kirill of Kazan, Archangel of Yaroslav, Andronicus of Perm, Hermogenes of Tobolsk, the priest, John, Peter, and Philosoph, and all the new hero martyrs and confessors of the Russian Church, of the holy, glorious, and victorious martyrs, of the holy, glorious, great martyr, trophy bearer, and one of worker, George, the holy, great martyr, and healer, Pantelimon, the holy, great martyr, Barbara, and the holy, believing Russian princes and passion bearers, Boris and Lev, and Igor, and the holy, right, believing passion bearers, Tsar Martin Nicholas, Tsaritsa Alexandra, the crown prince Alexis, the princesses Olga, Tatiana, Maria, and Anna Cecilia, and the holy nun martyrs, Grand Duchess Elizabeth and Nun Barbara, and the all new martyrs of Russia, of our venerable and God bearing fathers, Anthony and Theodosius of the Kiev Caves, Sergius the Abbot of Regeneration, Seraphim of Sirol, Job, Abbot and Wonder Worker of Pochaya, of the holy righteous John of Kronstadt, of the holy blessed Xenia of St. Petersburg, of our venerable and God-bearing Father, Sermon of Alaska, Vinicius Velichovsky, Leo Macarius, Ambrose, and the other elders of Octana, of the Holy Hero, Hierarchs, Innocent of Moscow, Nicholas of Japan, John of Shanghai and San Francisco, and the righteous saints Peter and Febronia, whose memory we celebrate, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, we pray thee, O Lord, purchasing mercy, hearken unto us sinners that pray unto thee, and have mercy on us. The mercy, compassions, and love for mankind of the only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with the most holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we've been continuing a series over the last several vigil services, discussing the traits, the values, and such that our parish holds to as part of fulfilling the mission that Christ gave us whether it's at the conclusion of Matthew or the conclusion of Mark, when he leaves his apostles, when he leaves his closest followers, he's very, very particular that they are to continue. They are to continue in following him. They are to continue in sharing about him. And what we have then is this fifth in this series of values, which is to evangelize. This is not a popular value, certainly not a popular value in the society that we live in a large part because it's a very misunderstood value. That is, how is it that a Christian should be evangelizing? How is it that this is good news to the people that we're speaking to? How is it that this is good news and not a millstone? It's good news and not bothering. Good news that can be received as good news, not only thrown as good news. So when we talk about this concept. It's a very expansive view that we have. We, earlier today, inside these walls, had the joy of baptizing a new Orthodox Christian. Now, I suspect that this new Orthodox Christian had no idea what was going on. He was about 6 weeks old. And as much as we baptize into a covenant, and how important this is, we also know that to baptize is not the end of the story. We don't raise the flag as if we've already won when someone has been baptized. We know that this is the beginning of the life in Christ. That everything up to there was a preparation for the beginning, and now the child begins in earnest. Whatever that life is, that is their beginning. And so this most basic form of evangelism begins. The one that we take for granted begins. That is the raising of children, the passing on of that faith from parent to child. We think of it as happening organically until we have the experience that it doesn't. We think of it as happening organically, as if just along with all the other things that are given to a child, one's own values and beliefs and things that underpin our outlook on this world and beyond is simply given to a child. But we know, when we look more carefully, that it doesn't just happen. It doesn't just happen because a good start has been made, any more than a race is won when the starter's pistol goes off. We see this passing on of the faith from parent to child as something that happens consistently and by life and by showing what matters most, by showing what is valued most. We see this very closely, just as we see these values distantly when we look at other people. So we have this form of evangelism, and we have, how do we share with those who we're not related to, who we don't share a household with? And we do this, well, firstly, a parish will do this mostly by facilitating. It's very difficult for a whole parish to have an evangelism strategy. What actually happens is that individuals will be involved in this. For a parish, what is vital is our hospitality. What is vital is our welcome. What is vital is that we are worshiping, that we are praying together, that we are moving closer and closer towards holiness, and then we're able to invite people to come along with the journey. And so where a parish is to support the efforts of its faithful to invite others. And I'll close with, how is it that this may happen? Because we're not all the same. And we can be very, very thankful that we're not all the same. This great diversity of talents and abilities, this is a wonderful thing. And we're not going to communicate in the same way. This also is a wonderful thing. So when it is that we are wanting to be able to share this hope that is within, we do this not only with our life, but this is necessary. It is necessary that we are doing our best to progress towards sanctity, towards holiness. Necessary that we are doing our best. But this is not all, because it's not about our life anyway. Christ is risen whether we are holy or not, whether we live like he's risen or not. And so we're simply pointing out the source of where our purpose is from. We're pointing to others because this is something that doesn't run out, something that we can share to its most infinite degree with others, with those who wish. And so when we are inviting others to likewise partake, to likewise taste and see that the Lord is good, we do this for, we are open about what it is that we do. We are open and we are sharing our own journey. From there we can invite others to share that too. In some ways, it's no different than sharing musical texts or sharing going to the cinema, sharing an event together. Yet it's not only this. But it need be no more complicated than this. Because as Paul told his people, it's not about us anyway. We're simply overflowing with God's love for us, that others can be a part of that too. And so, wherever we are, wherever we find ourselves during the week, we can know that the support is there, the facilitation is there, that we can invite others to share this journey to heaven, this journey to authenticity, this journey to becoming truly human with all of those around us, so that we may all journey together and may celebrate with God in heaven together. Amen.
Understanding with him. Holy righteous, the great God for us.
us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Holy to remembrance of us, holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady, the ever-present, ever-Virgin Mary, of all the saints, let us commit ourselves to one another and all our life to Christ our God. For thou art our God, and to thee we send our glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
Amen. Honoring the transitory glory and covenants of this God, with this fancy of pious and peace for all wise and burning us fast of people, gazing by the palms of the entrance, wherefore lying it separately and assuming it even after death, invisibly and half hidden, pray now to Christ, who is every sinner that he would glorify thee. May it clear my tongue, and pacify my heart, and heart and mouth, and thirst with the Spirit of wisdom, that therewith I may do utterance and charm us with thy wonderful works. Rejoice with all praise, the burning of blessed people. Rejoice, allies of the man of Russia, and helpers of the Orthodox princes. Rejoice, preservers of our command, and proclamation of our city. For all minds to win, will be comforted, and praise of Christ, be preserved our city, and that he will glorify you. May faithfulness hasten to the blessed and splendid serenity of being in the burning as to the shining sun, and let us unceasingly cry out, even though it pass from this earth full of glorious ones, live not farther from us, but stand the angels before the Trinity, whom do ye entreat that our souls be saved? Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both then and peace of his Son. Christ our God, who became a part of the being, has acknowledged to be the word of the Father, of God, and their darkness, who are not pure and blessed. Wherefore, chanting and ceasingly magnify thee. Spiritual record, for the fruit of life and God,
Annunciation, Febronia, great God for us. We grant that the seed of precious bodies have been sanctified, divine and blessed patron Febronia. We seek communion through men glorify Christ who are glorified in your blood. Holy righteous patron Febronia, great God for us. Even though you have passed from the sky, yet you have attained unto the abodes of heaven, where you stand at the angels of all the Trinity, whom do you treat the first one who will God be the same, O all blessed ones. Holy righteous mission of Gloria, great God for us. Heavenly fires, all radiant stars, and heaven set of sun, will burn land first with cherishing the whole world of memory of Peter and Gloria. Holy righteous mission of Gloria, great God for us. O all the flame, O all radiant angels, will you lift up all the world to sing the light unto bodies, will you lead you above goodly lands unto your own love. Take not the earth, Lord, and polish him with all your song. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Let ye high rites and priests, ye monks in labor, ye elders and youths, and people of every age, lay up in splendor, magnify in memory of your glorious patron, Febronia, and hymns, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Remaking us then a temple of Christ, side our supplications to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Make us also to be temples of all your one, rendering us
of Thank you.
flesh and days that is called the Word, the very theos of his future being magnified. He hath opened his servant Israel in the heavens of his mercy, as he spake to our fathers to Abraham in the city forever. Glory to God and to Israel with him, as we have prepared for glory to the servant. The Lord of corruption gets back to God the Lord, the very parents of the city we magnify.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the divine blessing. death and chamber, the bridegroom from the bridal chamber, making these captive and abolishing them, through the supplications of those who gave you birth, thus send them light upon us, a light illumining our hearts and souls, a light which directed all toward the vast and deep thy precepts in the ways of peace.
Thank you.
Peaceful,
God and guardian of us, souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That Christian and into our life, painless, blameless, peaceful and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
All things to remembrance of us, holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the ever person, ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves to one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
The power of God, of mercy, compassion, and love for mankind, and to thee we send our glory. The Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all. Let us bow our heads unto the
Thank you.
As once rescued out of sufferings of the atonement,
Glory to thee, O Christ, God, glory to thee. Especially if you'd be interested to know about the things that are going on within the parish and the future things that will be happening, so that, you know, if you have something to contribute, that's an opportunity to do so. Have a blessed night. We'll see you in the morning, hopefully.